welcome to DNN, the Dank News Network. My name is Kuzon. For those of you who are just joining us, we are a weekly newscast dedicated to reporting the events in Lords of Minecraft. Lord Roman lit up the Christmas tree last Saturday using a special ornament, fire. Roman burned the tree with flint and steel and also struck it with lightning several times. He also murdered dozens of peasants with lava and lightning. Electricity Man tried to rehabilitate him, but failed to put up the Christmas tree or save anyone. A res beacon was placed after the incident, and the tree mysteriously restored itself back to normal a few hours later. The Lord's Mall opened last Wednesday at midnight. We go to our field reporter for a closer look at the new market. The Lord's Mall opened Wednesday, and with it, an entire new economy for the city of Dong Dank. Peasants can purchase food, alcohol, books, and more.
They're selling fan fiction in Lords?
Yeah.
That's amazing!
Amazing.
The mall also features new hats, masks, and emotions for peasants to buy using special Lord currency called SS Stones. The hype surrounding the mall's opening attracted most of the city. On Friday, Dong Dank was filled to max capacity. The current spectacle of the mall gives stores enough business to not only stay open, but make a profit. Not all mall owners make money their top priority, though.
The goal is not necessarily that you're going to get all these items, and you're going to go to a shop, and you're going to make your money back, even. That's not really the goal. The goal is that you get to play restaurant or a bar. We just want to make it a fun, cool environment for people just to kind of hang out. It's just a different experience, I guess.
The Ocean Nymph's Maid Cafe, for example, specializes in personal service. Each guest gets their own waitress, which allows for great one-on-one discussions in a restaurant setting. Despite anticipating losses, the Maid Cafe made most of their money back in the first 2 days. This is because the mall items are much more expensive than they need to be. In order to make one's money back on the contract and the mall plot, a merchant would have to sell each item for 2 to 4 gold coins. However, the average price for a mall item currently rests at 11 coins. Nobody seems to mind, though, as 11 coins seems small when the average peasant makes 180 coins a day. There is also the current issue of inflation in the market. Before the mall opened, peasants only earned money to buy a plot and pay their rent. Since rent is quite cheap, longtime residents slowly accumulated a surplus of gold and had nowhere to spend it. Now that the mall is open, peasants are spending this surplus on overpriced items without a second thought. As the mall hype dies down and business slows, peasant wallets will begin to thin out, and the mall's economy will stabilize. The balance between consumer and producer may begin to waver, but for now, current mall owners can enjoy playing restaurant with no financial worries. From the Lord's Mall, this is Kuzon for DNN. In a related story, the Nismas Toy Shop opened up last Saturday evening. Peasants can earn money by going to the workshop in the market square and wrapping presents for Santa Claus. King Pooh's promises gifts for all peasants in the form of SS stones if the city can make the quota of 72,000 gifts by Christmas. If the city fails, all peasants get coal. The quota motivates people to use their stamina potions at the factory, especially those who have been hoarding them. Peasants will need to combine their efforts over the next 8 days to reach the goal. A mysterious present appeared in the middle of the lake last week. No one knows why it's there, how it got there, or who put it there. A pipe connects the enormous gift to the sewage plant, but none of the staff constructed the pipe or know anything about it. No one knows the contents of the Christmas gift, but the poor wrapping job indicates that it has something to do with ice. DNN will keep you posted on any developments concerning the mysterious package. That's all for this week's news. My name is Kuzon. Tune in next time for more on the recent events in Lords of Minecraft. Thanks for watching.